What do you think about this electrocardiogram? What is your interpretation?
Right bundle branch block, or RBBB, is a kind of ventricular conduction defect that interrupts impulse conduction in right ventricle. Any kind of disturbance in conduction system, including RBBB, can cause QRS widening. Therefore, RBBB, LBBB, and nonspecific IVCD are three main causes of broad QRS due to conduction system defect. As we said in previous episodes, in addition to wide QRS complex, there are two extra criteria for detecting RBBB in surface EKG. First, prominent R or RSR prime pattern in V1, which is the hallmark of RBBB. And second, slurred S in V6 and other lateral leads. Let's go through three real examples. The present strip belongs to 36-year-old female, known case of hypertension, presented with dyspnea. What do you think about this strip? Does it require any immediate intervention? Before going through the EKG strip, pause the video and try it yourself, then play the video again and compare your findings with the correct answer. Duration of QRS complexes is 3 small squares, so the complexes are wide. Furthermore, there is RSR prime pattern in V1, in association with broad S wave and lateral leads, which establishes RBBB as the cause of QRS changes in the present strip. Even under pathologic conditions, RBBB is a nonspecific finding and may be caused by a number of factors. So, RBBB does not have any specific treatment and does not require any medical intervention as well. Our second strip is taken from a 40-year-old man with burning epigastric pain. Again, pause the video and do it yourself. Then we go through it together. QRS complexes are obviously broad. Other associated findings are RR prime pattern in V1 and slurred S wave in lateral leads. So, the QRS complex changes are owing to RBBB. Furthermore, QRS complexes are positive in D1 and negative in D2, so left axis deviation is present as well. Remember that RBBB does not cause axis deviation. Therefore, RBBB with left or right axis deviation is due to bifascicular block. In patients with bifascicular block, concomitant structural heart disease is frequently present. So, careful screening for signs and symptoms of occult cardiac disease is essential. In asymptomatic patients with no suspected heart disease, further cardiac evaluation is not required. Our last example is a 55-year-old female with history of hyperlipidemia, presented with localized chest pain. Again, pause the video and interpret the strip on your own. Then we go through it together. QRS complexes are 3.5 small boxes in duration. On the other hand, there is RSR prime pattern in V1, with prominent slurred S in lateral leads. So QRS complex changes are due to right bundle branch block. Thanks for watching this video. If you are interested in learning electrocardiogram by real EKG cases, subscribe me and ring the bell. Have fun!